Nighttime finally came. The moon was full, and the stars twinkled in the sky. The fog soon came down, and fast. Thomas, Percy, and Toby soon split up and waited for the ghost of Timothy to emerge. Percy headed off on the shortcut route to get to the docks. When he got there, his driver and fireman heard a whistle, followed by a sadistic laughter.
Oh no, it's Timothy!
And so it is!
There was Timothy, looking so evil, twisted, demented, and very psychotic. His eyes beaming with red and his zombie-like teeth grinning from both sides of his mouth. Behind him were the coaches, the very same ones he pulled with him on the day of his suicidal crash. Inside them were the shadowy shapes of the passengers that died with him.
Quick! He's coming after us! I think we lost him.
We haven't lost him! He's still on to us!
Timothy's laughter came, and it sounded like he was coming in closer from behind. Percy wasted no time and was on the move again. He crossed Crow's Farms Crossing, past Hackenbeak, and arrived at the big station where Toby was waiting.
He's coming!
So I can hear!
Straight to hell!
as the engines continued to fly along, they got turned off onto a different line. But the ghost train was nowhere to be seen. They thought they had lost him, when suddenly they heard him whistling loudly from behind in the distance. But then another whistle was heard.
Leave this to me. Timothy's so messed up in the smoke box that he'll have no idea what's about to happen.
I am not going without taking Sula with me! Prepare to be sent to the graveyard, Thomas, for your death has come at the hands of Timothy, the Ghost Train of Sodor!
And your death came at the hands of Thomas the Tank Engine.
Thomas knew that this had to be done to end Timothy's reign of horror. Hours later, Percy, Thomas, and Toby stayed in the sheds. None of them could even speak to one another after what they had just gone through. Even their drivers and firemen could not get over the night's event as they went to sleep in the workman's hut. This was a night of horror that they hoped to forget forever.